Arches National Park. Temperature still 62 degrees at 1:30 local time. We saw a lot of great trails. There's a lot of trails, a lot of walking trails from easy to, you gotta have a park ranger to go. So, man, we're so glad we came. We're driving through at the end of the road that goes up to the very, I guess you call it, north end. I think they call it what, Devil's Garden, maybe, babe?
Devil something, let's see.
A lot of people out here.
Devil's Garden Campground.
Yep, so there's a campground up here, so look it up if you want to camp in Arches. Got a little picnic area up here when you come up during the day. We got bathrooms up here at the end.
And this park, you do have to bring your own food because there is nowhere to get concessions and stuff like that.
Unless there's something down at the visitor center.
I looked on the whole thing and there's nothing. Unless you eat it. Yeah, exactly. But I mean, that, like Grand Canyon stuff has got places you can go and eat. There's nowhere like that here.
The bathrooms that we found in this park were very clean. Good job, Arches National Park staff. We've been to some other ones that's just horrendous.
Oh, Lord.
But the campground is off to the right. Let's go through the campground in case you want to go camping. That's what this
says. It's full, too. Golly.
Yep, I say it's all full. What? Did it say on the brochure what the fee is? Picnic tables. No wood gathering. No ground fires.
Devil's Garden Campground has 50 sites. 18 miles from the park entrance. No RV or trailers permitted on the group site. May only camp dead site. No, it should, let's see.
Well, they got nice little spots, as you can see. Most of them got a tag on it. It says reserved.
It says the campground is usually full daily between March and October.
I can see why. Man, this would be great if you want to come up here, bring your Class C, your travel trailer. There's a little Class C.
It has nothing on here about the prices, though. Park fees, let's see something. Entrance fees, camping fees. Devil is $25 per site per night. Jupiter site, ooh, it's $100 to $250 a night based on the group. And then Canyon Ring Group is $75 to $160. So $25 a night for this one. And you can use your generator certain hours.
Now, there was a couple that we saw in the other arch that came out this way, babe.
Do what, babe?
The trail that kept going through that arch that we were at. It must come out here on this back side, because that was the same couple that walked through that we were waiting to take the picture.
It's an ISO. I don't know what the length is, though. It doesn't say. Maddie wouldn't fit.
I bet
fit.
You're back down in your 30 feet, because there's...
Maddie would not fit, I can tell you that.
Maddie around some of these corners. We'll be dropping it off. Oh, there's a fifth wheel right there that's probably ever been 30 feet, huh?
Yeah.
Nice little bathrooms up here.
Looks like it'll tell you. It'd be really cool to stay up here, though.
Yeah, it would. Be really nice.
So that's some of those group ones. they had just tons of people over there. I guess if you travel like that, it'd be really nice.
El Monte RV, like, see a lot of rentals up here coming out of California. So if you've never tried it, go rent you an RV. Fill it up with gas and go. Try it out, see if you like it. Those smaller ones, you can just drive everywhere usually. So anyway, that's the campground here. All right, on to our next adventure.